Thanks for joining us on the John Mendola Show. We are driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers. So let's talk King's College women's basketball. Caitlin Hadzmichalis is the new head coach. And Caitlin, welcome into the show, but a lot of familiarity for you with the King's women's program.
Yes, definitely. Thank you for having me on here. And we've been listening to you, and you've done a great job with a lot of the local sports, especially women's basketball. So we appreciate it, and I appreciate you calling and checking in.
Well, Caitlin, boy, what a background you have. Not many people could do one sport in college. You happen to do three at Marywood.
Yes.
And carry a GPA of like 3.85 or something like that. Boy, you can really balance some stuff. So you seem like the perfect person to connect with these young ladies and say, hey, I did it. I know you could do it. And then you really got to manage your time.
Definitely. It was something that I really wanted to do when I was going into college. I just loved playing all three sports. I didn't really want to have to choose. And I had the opportunity to be able to play all of it. But as for going through it, I mean, I've been on a ton of teams from the time I could run around. So I feel like that's one of the things that's helped prepare me to be a coach is I've seen a bunch of different coaching styles. I've learned from a bunch of different people from all over. So I think that's one of the things that really got me into coaching. So, yeah, definitely I can help in the time management portion of things.
Let's talk about your philosophy and working with Brian Donoghue there at Kings for all those years and, of course, having your own philosophy, as you said, being around some different coaches during your time.
Yeah, definitely. I had a great experience working with Brian Donoghue, the former coach. I learned a ton under him. And there's a lot, not just on the floor. Obviously, I learned a ton of basketball from him, but just how to handle yourself professionally day to day and how to just really do a good job of maintaining relationships with people in and around the business. So that was a lot of experience that I really can't thank him for. And I'm excited for his new experience up at the University of Vermont. As far as it goes for me, coaching philosophy-wise, I mean, I'm very big on details. I'm going to make sure that we're on point with everything in and outside of the classroom. I really want to make sure that we're doing the small things like footwork and getting the ball position right when we're going to shoot. I think those types of things will help get us in better spots to then be able to turn it into production on the floor. I really want to make sure that we're going to be a little bit more offensive minded with some of our production ideas. We weren't as great shooting the ball the last couple of years, so that's going to be a big focus coming into the season is how are we going to turn that into consistent production. And then defensively, same idea. I want to start using our length because we have some long bodies with the former roster, but as well as new players coming in. We've gotten longer and taller, so that's something that it's going to be a lot of fun to play around with defensively.
Caitlin, you come to us from New Jersey, Belvedere High School, and of course you found Northeastern Pennsylvania with Marywood, and now of course with Kings. What's it like to be here? And I guess there's a lot of familiarity there at Kings for you to, you know Cheryl Ish and you know JP Andraco, you know the campus, you know what kind of student athletes will come to Kings and put out a good product for you on the floor. So I'm sure that familiarity helped you a little bit. And this year, this is your second home now.
Oh, absolutely. The roundabout way that I ended up at Kings is through Brian Donoghue. His wife was my athletic trainer when I was in New Jersey and in high school, and we just kind of kept tabs on each other. And when I graduated, and Brian offered me the job to work with him, like you said, I already know the area a little bit through Marywood and the Scranton portion of things. And then being over here at Kings for the last 7 years, I've really gotten to know a lot of the local basketball coaches, youth, high school, all over. I also worked at Pittston for a little bit while I was coaching at Kings with field hockey, so I know a bunch of people in that area. So I think it's really been to my benefit to understand, like you said, the area of who's going to succeed here, who's going to fit in here, and that's going to make recruiting a lot easier for me. I mean, we've always done well keeping local players that are good in the area at Kings, so to now be able to branch out and maybe get a little bit back towards home, towards New Jersey, or get into maybe that southern tier of New York that's not too far from Scranton that I've gotten to know, like Binghamton-wise. That's something that I'm looking forward to do. And then just with everything else going on, I think that's where it's been a good comfort zone for me to come back to Kings and now be in the one chair. I'm not going to have to worry about going around, oh, where's the cafeteria, or having to learn a tour to take a family around to it. It's something that I'm already comfortable with. It's something I'm familiar with. So I'll be able to really focus on getting those X's and O's and the practice plans and the player development in and out of the classroom down.
And, of course, the recruiting part of this whole thing, you've had a big role with that, getting in and out of schools and grinding and going night after night while you're not playing and not practicing, but checking out some talent and traveling. I'm sure Brian kind of leaned on you a lot over the last few years, and it's been something that you're going to say, hey, I kind of know this routine. I know what I'm doing.
Definitely. I mean, that's one of my favorite parts about coaching college-wise. You're able to go to different towns. You're able to do some of that traveling and see different gyms and meet different people and go through and figure out different local areas and talk to people up there about, hey, who can play that maybe we don't know about. So that's one of the things that I personally enjoy about coaching the college game, and something that I've been excited that Brian let me do early on in my career as an assistant. I mean, I worked with him for 7 years, and my first year he was taking me out and teaching me how to go about things the right way. So it's something that I really enjoy with it. I've also worked a bunch of camps, even when I was in high school and college, going to different places and meeting a bunch of people that way. So it's a really good tool to just get to know different areas and see different players and different style of plays within those areas. I've been able to work over at Cookstown. They've done a team camp for a while. I've worked Bucknell's elite camp, so you get to see a lot of those academic students who are on their radar as well, and we're able to pull from there. So it's been a lot of fun in that aspect, going out on the road and recruiting, and now it's going to be a new challenge, but a fun challenge that I'm excited about to create my own plan and start bringing in my own type players.
And that campus right now is buzzing. Men's ice hockey, track and field, a lot of changes going on at Kings. Lacrosse is getting a new coach, so there's really going to be some great developments that only helps in the recruiting process for you to say, we have all this to offer and a little bit more. And I think that gym right there, right on Main Street, helps as well.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the buzz around campus is really, really fun atmosphere to be involved in. And it's definitely going to be a big talking point when we are talking to families and recruits saying, hey, Kings is putting a lot into expanding its campus, expanding its athletics, expanding its academics. I mean, the academics is one of the things that is really easy for me to sell to families because it is so good. And our program specifically, in the last couple of years that we've been at Kings, our women's basketball program has finished 4 times in the top 25 academically with all Division III schools in the country. So for our guys to be able to show up, go to class, and get the grades to prove it, and have that same success on the floor is something that we've proved we can do at Kings, and that's definitely one of the main traditions I plan on continuing there. And then I think the other aspect, like you're saying, with bringing in the new sports with the ice hockey, men's and women's, and having a new lacrosse coach and getting the track built, I think it's a great opportunity. As you said before, I was a three-sport athlete, so I think the best way to get your campus involved is going to other games and going to other teams' events and being involved in an athlete-specific community. And if you're going to go out and support each other, that's the way you get people in the stands. And our stands are a lot nicer than a lot of stands in the country, I believe. I mean, our gym has been fantastic facility-wise. Our weight room has got a lot of upgrades, and it's doing a lot of positive things with all of the athletic teams in our department. So I'm really excited to get people reaware if they've forgotten about how good our facilities are, and bring in new families so they can kind of be a part of this hype of the new the building down on the square, Kings on the Square, and the new programs that they're starting to offer and the new athletic team. It's just a really exciting time to be at Kings.
Yeah, what a selling point you do have with your own grade point average, with that top 25 there for the women's basketball team academically. All the parents have to be very pleased at that component. Let's talk about the conference and the competition overall. And there's some really good teams, and you want to be towards the top.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, we have Fairleigh Dickinson down in Madison, New Jersey. They've been a national contender. They won a national title. Short period ago, and they're constantly going back. I mean, DeSales University is a perennial team that we've always had a good rivalry with and always have great coaching matchups against. And then now you have the local programs. I mean, Ms. Ricordi just got a new coach who's a great guy who's going to go in there and get some excitement over there. So to competition is always big time in our conference with the MAC Freedom. So that's another selling point, I believe, for the type of players that I want to recruit, that you're going to get to play against the best. Our conference is top-notch, no matter who you're playing, top to bottom. And that's how we are going to be able to eventually earn at-large bids like we did back in 2012. That was the year we ended up losing the championship, but because we play in our conference in the way that we believe in scheduling, we need to be ready every night. And if we do well in that, we're setting ourselves up to be back on that national scale. So that's definitely one of the other traditions on the court I plan on continuing, is just going out and playing the best in league and out of league, because that's not what every conference gets across Division III. So definitely going to utilize that.
Caitlin Hadzmichalis, 7 years as an assistant coach, just the sixth head coach in the history of the program. It started 1974-75 season there at Kings, and she definitely is ready to go. And congratulations, Caitlin. We'll look forward to seeing your product out there on the court come November.
Thanks, John. I really appreciate it, and I'm just ready to get on the floor.
Kings College women's basketball brand-new head coach Caitlin Hadzmichalis, quite familiar with the program here on the John Mendola Show. We are driven by McCarthy Tire and Automotive Centers.